You crazy for this one, Rick.
Right now you riding around with me once again. It's your host Q, your favorite host, Who's Driving Hip Hop. Now, we definitely got a special guest, a special treat for the ladies. I don't know if you've been living under a rock lately, but if you've been watching America's Next Top Model, we got something special for y'all ladies. Just watch and see. We back with the famous Keith Carlos.
What's good, what's good, what's good?
Chilling, man. So last time we saw you, you was announced the winner
of America's Next Top Model.
ever since then, I've seen you on tour, as I would say, the circuit. Saw you doing interviews everywhere. How's that been going, man?
Man, it's been going cool. It's been moving slow motion, really just building my team and pretty much taking opportunities as they come, trying to make this whole platform I got something big.
Definitely. So for those that don't know at home, you started playing football
right
at first, right? New York Giants.
Uh-huh.
Now how you get into the whole modeling thing?
Well, I got into the model. I was always told I should model, you know, based off of my looks and whatnot. You know what I'm saying? I say that as humbly as possible. But it's something that I was never really able to really jump into because of school and football was so time consuming. So once my career with the Giants pretty much ended after I tore my hamstring, I had nothing but time, so I kind of jumped into it and I got the opportunity to go on Top Model.
So what was it like going into it? Was you nervous? Like, because I feel like you look at models as the pretty boys. So coming from a manly sport like football, then having to go to the pretty boy model.
Pretty boy new. Cap out for side, y'all know. So, you know,
that was an easy transition.
That was. So, you know, I was basically myself. It was a smooth transition.
Okay.
Just had to, you know, learn on the go, basically, you know. My mentors, you know, Tyra and all them, they pretty much, you know, help you out along the way. You just gotta, you know, be able to take the critiques that they give and apply them on the go.
Yeah.
So it's just like taking critiques from a coach.
Uh-huh.
You know, so I feel like I had one up on everyone else.
So what was the difference? What was the difference between playing football and modeling?
The difference? there's only a physical difference, you know. It's the same. You have to approach the two with the same amount of enthusiasm and the same amount of tenacity. Because you got to work hard at both, you know. It's a lot of work to model, actually. You know, from a diet standpoint, like really mentally locking in and, you know, owning your whole diet. And
so what kind of diet are you on during the show? Now I see how you eat. You don't eat that great. So during the show, what kind of diet were you on? What were you staying away from? Or what were you
eating more of? Honestly, they was feeding us. They was feeding us on the show.
Good.
Like real good. I'm talking lobster, whole chickens, you know what I'm saying? But meals were spaced out.
Yeah.
So we wasn't eating as frequent, but was eating a lot, like big portions of whatever.
So look, man, y'all at home, Who's Driving Hip Hop, stay tuned. We still here with Keith Carlos. Y'all check out this video.
Tuition cost, money sacrificial. The issue is we just want it all. If you don't want it all, then what the hell you searching for? These cars and these clothes and these hoes. Oh, I get it, you want it. I see my last stuff in my pocket. Never cry broke, my thoughts think profit. I can tell when we ain't got it. I'm saying fuck it to my problems. A nigga trying to solve them. We got questions with no answers. My nigga, I gotta solve them. I get it. We solving problems through this liquor. My nigga, pray for your liver. Hey sister, cry you a river. Consider the world gets easy when you grinding. Just believe me. No wishing, no need for genies. Believe me, you gotta get it. Cause the world don't give a finic.
And we back. So what photographers do you like working with?
My favorite, it just depends on the editing really of the photographer and like how they capture images. I really don't have a favorite, yeah. But if I had to pick one in the Atlanta area, I would have to go with my man Carlos Jones.
Okay. Shout out to Carlos Jones. What about him makes him your favorite?
He's creative, you know, and he throws stuff out there on the go, like as we're going. He's just coming up with new ideas, and I love the texture of his images and how he edits it, you know. It's not super, you know, fake porcelain, yeah. You know what I'm saying? So it's cool.
So in the modern world, you're new to the game.
Yeah.
So what models inspire you? What models do you look at? Do you try to pattern your game? Because I know you play receiver. So I know you probably looked at the Jerry Rice and the Tim Brown that you were pattern your game after playing receiver. So what models, or if any, do you pattern your game after, or that you like to take little advice from?
I like the boy Sean O'Pry.
Okay.
He's actually from Kennesaw, Georgia. He's the highest paid model. You know, had all the major campaigns. Of course, Tyson Beckford. You know, he opened some doors for myself and
Speaking.
What you mean?
About Tyson.
Oh my God. What's up?
So what? I hear there's beef between y'all two.
Not at all.
I seen the little Twitter post that he blocked you from Twitter Insta. Like, what's that all about?
Man, I don't know, but it is what it is, man. I wish him nothing but the best, and it was probably a glitch or something.
Probably. Tyson, man, get that fixed. Is it because y'all look like twins? Hey, man, get that fixed. We figuring out what's wrong, man. Unblock my man. Y'all check out. Hey, y'all check out this other video, man. Actually, man, check out this clip from America's Next Top Model with your boy Keith Carlos. Okay. And we signing out.
21, baby.
First time ever. Or Keith, the sexy pro football player aiming for a top model touchdown.
I sustained a career-ending injury in football. So now, me as a model, everything that's on my mind is win. Win, 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 win.
Look at these two beautiful models that have come so far. And I know you want to walk in that fashion show, don't you, Keith?
Yes, I do.
And Lennox, I know you want to stomp in that fashion show, don't you?
I do.
So who's going to? The model that will be competing in the Lee Songbong fashion show against Adam and Will is... Keith.
Okay.
Congratulations. You are the last finalist.
Thank you.
There are male models and guys everywhere rejoicing. And there are female models going, what the hell? Me included. But you deserve this.
Thank you.
Congratulations. So, Lennox, got so far. So far. I think the judge...
Tyra picked me over Lennox, and Lennox is a strong model. It just made me be even more appreciative of where I'm at.
It's getting realer and realer.
May the best man win.
I have no time for slacking because I'm not doing it for me. I'm doing it for my family, and I need to cry. That's what I need to do to make myself feel better. I'm just numb to a lot of things because of everything I've been through, everything I've lost. I come from the bottom, you know, from Bridgeport, Connecticut, and the housing projects. My father wasn't in the picture, and then he passed away, so I felt alone, but I'm still breathing, and I'm fighting, and his fight is over. So I'm fighting for tomorrow's our last runway show, and winning is at reach. You know, your boy's gonna bring it. I'm bringing the lineup, and it means everything to see my mother, you know. Seeing her face pushes me forward and helps me get through these hard, long days. Man, it's amazing. I miss the hell out of you. Family is number one in my life. Hey, sister. I miss you, sister. How are my nephews doing? Oh, yeah, kiss them for me. My nephews, they're in the projects right now as we speak. I know how I want my kids to live, and I know how I want my nephews to live. So I have to pull them out of that environment. I love y'all, and I'll speak to you soon.
And we back. So how do you feel about the controversy? As far, like, the weight, like, because that's the biggest thing you hear about models. They don't eat, right. You know, or they got to stay on a strict diet, or you're too tall, you're too small. Like, how do you feel about everything?
I don't know, man. I feel like that's a stigma, or it just pertains to women. But men, I seen models eat, you know, skinny, fat, I seen them all eat, like,
yeah.
Like grown men, but, me, I just, you know, pretty much stay within my own little diet, my own routine, and it works for my body type, so I don't try to change too much.
Hold on.
Only thing that really changed is my workout routines, you know, is more cardio. I don't lift heavy weights like that no more, and my diet is low sodium, so. Mm.
What's your advice to any aspiring models out there right now that want to get in the game, that wants to model? Because to me, I feel like that's something that's harder to do than acting, rapping, playing sports. Because like you said earlier, the stigma that comes with modeling.
Right.
So what's your advice to aspiring models, male or female out there?
Number one, I would tell you to have a vision. And with that vision, you got to believe in yourself, because the mind thinks the body is following. And you got to have thick skin, because people are going to tell you can't do something or you're too busy, too bad. So you got to just own it. And you got to believe in yourself, you know what I'm saying? And just go get it. You gotta be a go-getter.
Gotta be a go-getter.
Oh, yeah. And once you get that vision, man, just own it. Like I said, it'll all work out for you. If it's for you, it's for you. If it's not, you'll find something else.
Yo, it's your boy Cupid, and you just tuned in to Who's Driving Hip Hop. You never know who's gonna be on my show and who's gonna be in the backseat of the whip, man, getting interviewed by me. So y'all stay tuned in to a few episodes of Who's Driving Hip Hop. And I'm out of here.